Carrie here from My Cloud Bookkeeping. Do you sometimes offer your customers or clients a discount and want to keep track of that separately? There's a way that you can turn on the discount feature in QuickBooks Online and track that discount amount separately. It's a really good idea just to monitor how much you're giving out in discounts. Perhaps you're not the only person granting the discounts and you'd like to see where they're going or how much they amount to on a regular basis. So we'll walk through those steps now.
So here we are in the sample company, and the first thing we need to do is turn on the discount feature. So we pop up here to the gear icon, go to Account and Settings, we select Sales, and here we have the option for discount, and we can see it's turned off. So we grab the little pencil, and let's toggle that to on. Then we click Save. Now what QuickBooks has done in the background while we've done this is it's created an account for us to record those discounts into. So let's have a look in our chart of accounts. And if we scroll down to the income section, we can see here it's created an account called Discounts Given. And it's created this in the income section so that when you're looking at your income statement, your profit and loss, you'll be able to see the income, the sales, and the discounts all in the one area. So now let's give somebody a discount and see how it works. So we pop up here, let's choose an invoice, and let's sell something to Cool Cars. I'm gonna invoice them for a design project for $50,000. Now if you have a look down here, we have the option for a discount percentage or a discount value. Let's give them a 10% discount. So here we now have $50,000 invoice with a 10% discount, and the balance due is $45,000. Now there's an interesting thing here with sales tax. I'm going to click tax amount here and put that check mark in so that it's going to calculate sales tax. We're just going to go with California just because it's there. And you can see that it's calculated the tax on the $45,000. Now there's an interesting thing that happens here. We can toggle this and then it will calculate the tax on the before discount amount. Now I cannot imagine a scenario where you would be charging the sales tax before the discount, but if that is something you need to do, that is an option. It's a little difficult to read in there, but now it's telling you that the taxable subtotal is $45,000 and it's calculating the sales tax on the net amount, which I think would be quite the normal thing to do. As I mentioned, I have no idea when you wouldn't do that. So now we can save and theoretically send that to Cool Cars. You can also use the discount on a sales receipt. So let's pop out of this. We'll go up here and we'll open a sales receipt. A sales receipt is something you use when the sale and the payment happen at the same time. So as you can see, the boxes are the same, except that we're also choosing where we're depositing the funds to. So we'll just grab our Cool Cars again. We'll give them a design service. Maybe we won't. Maybe we'll just sell them some lighting because they're here in the store and it's $500. I'm going to take off the tax, make things a little easier. And maybe this time we're just going to give them some dollars discount. So we'll give them, I don't know, a $50 discount. It's 10%, same sort of thing, but you can see another way to use this. They will give you your $450, which you'll either pop into undeposited funds and go to the bank later, or you'll, if they're paying you by credit card, you might be putting directly into your checking account. Then we can save and send, save and print, do whatever we need to do with that one. Now, if you're preparing an estimate for a client, you can pop into here, grab your estimate. And if you have a look, you still have this option to use the discount feature in here as well. So when that's accepted, the discount will flow through for your invoicing. I have a different video on using estimates if that's something you'd like to explore further. But for discount purposes, it works exactly the same as the invoice and the sales receipt. Now let's have a quick look at the income statement, the profit and loss, and see what's going on in there. So we'll pop up here to reports. Now we'll go to our profit and loss. And you can see here we have design income, we have discounts given, we have other services. So we can see that the total income here is $55,650. It would have been over $60,000 if we hadn't given this discount. So you can keep an eye on the total discount that you're giving to your customers. Make sure that you're covering off your cost of goods sold and that you then have enough money left to cover all your operating expenses. This is really important that you're looking at this on a regular basis. The other thing to consider here is we don't have account numbers in the sample company, so it's doing everything in alphabetical order. I don't particularly like how this looks. If you wanted to change that around, you could add some numbers, you could organize things however you wanted, and hopefully that would be a little bit more useful. But here we go. We can see we've given $5,000 discount on a total income of $55,000, so that's quite significant.
So do keep in mind what your costs are when you're offering those discounts. Sometimes you'll have salespeople in the field and they'll just be wanting to close the sale. You might need to have some strong policies around what discounts can be offered and when, particularly during these tight times. And with costs increasing quite significantly at the moment, so make sure you know what it's costing for what you're selling, be they services or products, and what your margins are to be sure you're not discounting too much. You can still cover your regular operating expenses. Make sure you're looking at your reports on a regular basis. Download the month-end checklist. It'll help to keep everything in order. This video was useful. I'd love to hear about it. Click like, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you again soon. Cheers.